This week's Ask Dr. Durie comes from a patient who wants to know, what is MRD? It seems like in 2017 and now in 2018, we're constantly talking about MRD. So it is important for a patient to know, well, what is that? So MRD means minimal residual disease. So then what is minimal residual disease? Well, this refers to the remaining amount, the residual amount of myeloma which is present in the bone marrow of a patient who has received therapy. For example, after a patient has had frontline therapy with VRD, for example, and then an autologous stem cell transplant, a bone marrow is done to assess the level of disease. In the past, what we would say is that there is 0% myeloma, so 0 myeloma cells out of 100, so 0%, and this is something that we have called complete remission. Now we have moved to a whole new level, and so now using different technology, using flow cytometry, using what is called NGF, next generation flow, or molecular techniques, very sensitive, called NGS, next generation sequencing, we can put the bone marrow sample through this very sensitive testing, and then we can assess if there's any myeloma at the level of 1 in a million or 0 out of a million. And this is called at the 10 to the minus 6 level. And so what we use right now is 10 to the minus 6 is an important cutoff. So 0 out of 1 million cells counted in the bone marrow. This means no myeloma cells at that level. This is a level at which patients clearly do much better in terms of the length of the remission and the overall survival. And so the bottom line is that this MRD, this minimal residual disease testing, is a very, very important endpoint, a key series of techniques to assess this level of response that we use in our clinical trials to guide us in determining if one treatment is better than another. Is there more evidence of deep responses with one treatment versus another treatment? And so in our clinical trials, this is now one of the key things that we are assessing. However, I'd like to emphasize that this MRD testing is not yet recommended across the board in the clinic because we are still studying what is the impact with frontline therapy. What about if you achieve MRD negative in the maintenance phase? Are we comfortable to stop therapy? So we have a lot of questions about how to use this information. But I think that for patients to understand what it means is incredibly important, and hopefully this is a sufficient explanation to guide patients forward in understanding the results that they might read about or hear about.